This is MBI.
This is the log. Wow. It's something which is very inspiring. I find it something which is very great, the bulb. Yeah, it's something which is thumbs up. Now, let me get started with Dennis here. This is Dennis. Yo, Dennis. How you doing?
How are you?
I'm good. So, I can say the branding is something which is very great and unique and something which is very robust. I'm kind of like, wow, this is amazing. Yeah. So, what do you think about the coding and all that and everything?
Basically, what we do, we try to do both mobile apps development and training. So specifically on training, because that's the impact that we're supposed to provide for Tanzania as a community. We are trying to train people on how to create mobile applications, especially youth. So at least we give them a chance to employ themselves during the time that they are in school and after finishing school. So we normally conduct this kind of trainings in terms of a boot camp. It can be a 10 days, 20 days boot camp, where people will come in and we'll train them on both areas of mobile entrepreneurship. And from there, we'll give them all the skills they will need to just employ themselves and start their own startup or any business that they like. And recently, we've been working with some of the organizations and some of the universities to train youth and train their teachers on a TOT programs. Especially now, for this year particularly, we are focusing on giving training on youth, specifically those who are in secondary, high school, and Form 4 and Form 6 students. We saw that as a way of which we can reach these people as early as possible before they make their career decisions, while the time they are going to college. The good thing about mobile application is when you apply it, it doesn't limit you to take any career. You can take as any career you like and still be able to become a mobile application developer. So someone can be a doctor but still is a mobile developer. Someone can be an engineer and still be a mobile developer and create solutions in the area or in the industry that they are in.
What about the challenges you guys do face sometimes? Like what are the challenges do you face?
Yeah, we have challenges. Most of the challenges we face is access to youth forums. Like you may have a nice idea on going to train youth maybe on a specific college. Now, with that, you need to write a proposal to a college and then the college should accept you to go and do a training. Sometimes it's even a free training. But because of the bureaucracy in terms of you get a chance or get a platform to access these youth, that's one of our challenges. The other challenge is finance. Basically, now we are looking into getting different investors who will invest in our boot camps so we can show what we can do with these youth, and then they will invest on the boot camp. So at least the cost for the training will be a little bit small. And we can reach as many youth as we can. So most of the challenge you're facing is the accessibility to different platforms for youth and also the finance part for so we can reach as many youth as we can.
Well, that's amazing. And what about technology in Tanzania? How do you find technology in Tanzania? It's like a question whereby a lot of people, like Western people, they're thinking that it's kind of hard to get those people who are enthusiastic on technology in our country. So what's your thoughts about technology in Tanzania?
My thoughts about technology in Tanzania, basically it's training. The technology, especially the mobile technology, is training. So I normally tell the people or our clients that we'll reach that level where each company, everybody who has done branding, we need to do branding on mobile apps or on mobile application, create solutions on mobile application. So the technology is trending. And the good thing today is the technology that US is using is the same technology we are using to create mobile applications. So there's no that gap anymore because of the internet and internet of things. So we have exactly what the other people in the other part of the world they are using. So the technology is really up, bringing solutions that we need for the community, and it's trending, and you can see people are now going into that mentality of applying technology in different challenges that they are facing. The Internet of Things, basically its main center is on data, because nowadays the world is being driven by data. So what we understand is if we put strategies that based on data which are already there on the internet, we create policies that focus on data which are already on the internet, and decisions should be made through these information that are already available on our data. So the Internet of Things can be used in a way that it's informative to people. Again, it can be used to reduce costs in terms of any project that you have, because like some of the projects that we work on is you don't have to go and collect data. Data already there. It's just a way you can put some analysis tools that you can get and filter the data that you really want. So we saw people taking a lot of cost in going to the field and collect data, which already those data are in place, so they can use it and leverage the Internet of Things and leverage the data that's already available by just putting some few tools for the analysis. My advice, I think it will be centered now on some of the things that we do. Number one, it's on mobile apps as a development career. One can take this career because it's a trending career. It's a career that will stay there for a long time. And regardless of who you are, regardless of what you do, you can take on mobile application as your career, as your second career. So you can be an engineer and still be able to create applications in the field that you're already in. So you can be a doctor, and if there are challenges that you face as a doctor, you can use a mobile app as a tool to solve those particular challenges. So that's part of mobile apps development. We encourage people who are already in the field, who are taking, let's say, degree programs or master's programs, even PhD, to take on these as one of the career that they can accomplish in their career journey. Another part is for training. We encourage universities and colleges and schools to try to look on the technology, the way it moves. So whatever they are training their students should be with the way the technology moves. So you don't teach people the outdated information. You don't teach people the outdated tools. So basically we want them to focus on the technology that they are trained in, the technology that they actually give the student power to employ themselves while the time they are still in school and after finishing school. And the other part that I would encourage is one of our campaign this year is about online citizenship. Basically, it's part of the technology. We encourage people to know this. This goes around to everybody, the Tanzania community in general. What do you supposed to put online and what you are not supposed to put online? Who do you want to interact with them online and what you should not interact with them online? So there are things that you are supposed to do and there are things that you are not supposed to do online. So the citizenship is the same as a normal citizenship, but online citizenship has its own rules and regulations. So we're trying to put this knowledge back to the community. So you know, what should I post on my Facebook account? What should I post on my Instagram account? What should I not put on my profile, and what should I not put on my account? So all this information, we want to put them in package of an online citizenship. The full company name is called Mobile Bootcamp Initiative. Our website is www.mbinitiative.com. Or you can check us on Instagram at MB Initiative, or you can check us on Facebook at MB Initiative, or you can check us on Gplus. But our main account website is mbinitiative.com. We are available in Arusha. That's our main operation center at Mega Complex Building, third floor. Say you want to go to MB Initiative, they will take you back to our office.